carbonate. The sea star is within a good to go in the asteroid.
Well, maybe. Full space. Sure.
Trying to do a quick scan right now.
So shrimp on the lower left hand side, and then all these crinoids are basically decorating the
lasers. No, sorry, I said there's lasers. No.
Okay, roger.
Let me know when you're clear,
video. He is clear.
Copy.
Pretty well calcified. Did you get the squat lobster on there?
Yeah, and there was, I just wanted to see if we could take a closer look at the larger colony above.
Sure. Very, very dense polyps.
Yeah, is this the white variety of the Enolapsamia, so maybe a different species than the yellow?
Free to zoom, roll.
Yeah, it could be. You know, it's clear from our other dives, and in general, Enolapsamia, as it gets older, it does sometimes lose a lot of its yellow pigmentation.
Come back a little.
So, I mean, the color isn't always a good indicator, like other taxa, for sclerotinians as well.
I think they might be different species than what's on the rock face, and as well as chirostylid of some type, or squat lobster in the middle.
Only one squat lobster.
You
can see the skeletons dark in color beneath the translucent tissue of this chrysogorgid octocoral. We've been seeing chrysogorgids.
Hi, Amanda. I just walked in, so I'm glad you said that. I was about to say something about this. I seem to recall about 3 or 4 dives ago, they're running together a little bit, that we saw.
All right, pilot.
That's
thanks.
Actually really nice showing all the crinoids as well, so if we can get several seconds of this.
Sure. Yeah, well, actually, we've just got a couple more seconds for video, and then we'll get it from the side, and I'll come around the other. Maybe a little tricky with it overhead.
Closing in on this coral. It looks like we have primnoid on the coral. It has a really large crinoid attached to one of the branches on the lower left. Looks a lot like the one we damaged before. Wow, really dense polyps.
Yeah, I would say, you know, this coral, based on the orientation of the polyps right now, they're probably closed down axis. I think there's probably
can
at least
down to the tip?
6 polyps per whorl that are used for identifying it further.
With lasers?
Go ahead, go pilot.
Is there a squat lobster in the upper right-hand corner with something in its claws? I think it's feeding. No, it's not feeding.
It's positioning.
It's adjusting its object that it's in its posterior appendages.
Yeah, it's, kind of, I guess, maybe pruning its camouflage.
Looks like one of those homolid crabs that we've been seeing throughout the expedition. It has what looks like an anemone in its posterior appendages, and then its chelipeds, or front arms.
It's important
good.
To look
that
good.
Was good.
Yeah.
Always have to look your best in the deep sea. You never know when you're going to be on camera.
That's what it looks like.
Are we on sunfade right now? We're not getting any response. Without anything in these rear legs. And this time we actually got to see them in action, possibly cleaning and eating food off of the anemone.
Could it be feeding its anemone?
It's really incredible color. I wonder how many different types of homolids we've actually observed
the
on the expedition, and if anyone's actually the whole.
Sure.
Maybe some of those type corals are alive.
Hold that zoom.
Yeah, I think the ones just above the lasers are alive.
Copy that.